In tiny liquor bottles, just what you'd expect. Inside her new Balenciaga viral mess, turned dreams into an empire, self-made success. Now she rolls with Rockefellers. Survival of the richest, the city's ours until the fall. They're Monaco and Hampton's bound, but we don't feel like outsiders at all.
Hello everyone. So today is my first vampy fall look that I've uploaded to my channel, and I am in love with it, obviously. And if you are too, then stay tuned and see how I created this look. Then I'm going in with this Benefit Brow Conditioning Primer, and I'm not really sure how I feel about this. I got it in my Birchbox this month. And I mean, it's okay. I don't know. I don't know how to feel about it. I haven't used it enough to, like, give you guys a full review of it or anything like that. So, stay tuned and I'll let you know. So, to start off this makeup look, I'm going in with, let's see. I think this is Jax. Yeah, I'm going in with Jax. It's kind of a cooler tone, like purpley, kind of burgundy shade. And I'm going in with my Kala 315 crease brush to do this. And I am just taking this shade and blending it into my transition area and a little bit down into the crease. And I am not taking a lot of this shade at first, just because I want this to be kind of like the base layout for where I want all the other shades to go. And then I'm going in with Chip on this little Real Techniques brush. Or is it? No, this is the It Cosmetics brush. I'm sorry. And with this color, I was a little heavy-handed, but honestly, this color is so pigmented, it is hard not to be heavy-handed. It's insane. But I'm taking this shade, and I am just putting it into the crease. And then the less product I get on my brush, I will blend up just a little bit. And then I'm also making sure that the outer edge of my eyelid is dark as well, because I want this look to be very bright on the inner corner and then fade like gradually out to a really, really dark, almost black shade. And then I'm going back in with Jax on that crease brush, and I'm going to go ahead and blend out that dark kind of cool tone brown color. And then I'm going in with the first shade in the Jaclyn Hill palette. It's called In Light, and I'm going in with this e.l.f. Defining Eye Brush. And I'm firstly going to apply this color right into my inner tear duct, into my inner corner. And I'm making this really, really, really bright. And then I'm just going to go ahead and apply this color all over the inner part of the lid. Like I said before, I really, really want this eye look to be really, really bright on the inner corner, and I want it to be really dark on the outer corner, but I want it to fade very gradually and very, very nice. So as you can see, whenever I apply In Light into the inner corner, I am bringing it up and just putting it everywhere on the inner part of my eye. Like, literally everywhere. And it is so beautiful. It opens the eyes up so much. And then I'm going to, of course, go back in with my little blending brush and make sure there's no harsh lines or anything like that. And then I'm going in with this Ico Skinny Eyeliner. And honestly, don't even ask me why I turned it upside down. I for real looked in my viewfinder and thought that I had it upside down in the first place. And then I actually had it right and I just turned it upside down. But it's okay. We all have our moments. So I am creating the thinnest wing that I possibly can. I got my right eye on camera, but the left eye was not happening. So this is how I did it for the right eye. Like I said, I am literally creating the thinnest wing possible, and I am winging out just a tiny, tiny little bit. And honestly, I wouldn't even call it winging out. I am just extending the line a little bit past where my natural eye ends. And then I'm going in with this little angled brush from Sonia Kashuk. And I'm going in with the shade Abyss from the Jaclyn Hill palette. It's just a really, really dark matte black shade. And I'm going to go ahead and start smoking out this eyeliner. And with this black shade, I am creating a wing. I didn't create the wing at first with my eyeliner because I don't want the wing to be really, really harsh. I want the eyeliner to be very blended out and look very smooth and clean. And then after I have the desired amount of black down that I want, I'm going in with this little e.l.f. eyeshadow brush with that dark purple shade. I can't remember if this is Jax or Chip. I think, honestly, I mixed both of them and put these on the outer edge of the eye. I was just looking at it after I got the eyeliner on, and I realized that the outer corner was not nearly as dark as I wanted it to be. And then after I get that done, I will go in and kind of perfect my wing with my eyeliner. And I know, I'm so out of focus for this, y'all. I was trying really hard, but it's just really hard to do your eyeliner and not be close to a mirror. And then I'm going back in with this black shade. And how I'm doing this is I'm basically just getting a lot of black on this brush. I'm not even gonna lie, it's a lot. You can honestly see the excess like flicking off whenever I do my eyes, but whatever. And so I'm taking this brush and I'm basically like putting it down onto the eyeliner, and I'm flicking it up, and I'm kind of like pushing the product in and then bringing it up so that it's very, very dark near the base of my lashes, but then it gets lighter the more that it goes up. And then I'm going back in with this little It Cosmetics brush just to blend a little bit. Then I am going in with some more of Chip. And I am just going to take Chip and run it all over the outer edge of my eye with this It Cosmetics brush. I am blending out the eyeliner and blending more of this dark shade into the outer corner at the exact same time. And then I'm going in with my crease brush, and I am blending everything. I am blending the crease out. I am blending the lid shades together. I'm using this brush to blend everything. And then I'm going to take some more of In Light, and this time I'm just going to use my fingers. This isn't necessary. You can still use the brush. I mean, the pigmentation is honestly the same because these colors are just so bomb that no matter how you use them, they look great. But I just felt like using my fingers. These colors are so creamy. I don't know. I guess I just like to touch them, honestly. And then, as you can see, this color, or I'm sorry, this look did get a little messy. So, I just went through with my makeup wipe and cleaned up my eyes. And that is why I love doing my eye makeup before my foundation, whenever I do dramatic looks like this. Because no matter how much fallout I have or how messy the outer edge of my eye is, I can just clean it up with a makeup wipe and it looks great. Then, to start off the face, I'm going in with Benefit's Professional Primer. And I'm going to go ahead and apply this with my fingers. And whenever I use this product, you have to be kind of careful. I always apply it. I will put some down and I press it into the skin and then kind of like wipe it down. Because if you go around in circular motions with this, it's kind of like it doesn't settle into your pores as well. But whenever I do it like this and press it down into my skin, it makes my skin look so flawless, you guys. I've been obsessed with this primer for like years, and it never ceases to amaze me, like ever. And then, as usual, I'm going in with my Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Foundation. I'm blending everything in with my Beauty Blender. Then I'm going in with my Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, and I'm going to go ahead and conceal underneath my eyes, down the bridge of my nose, on my Cupid's bow, chin, forehead, and underneath my cheekbones. And then I'm blending everything in with that same Beauty Blender from before. Then, to set everything, I am going in with my Maybelline Fit Me Loose Finishing Powder, and I'm taking this on my Beauty Blender, which is still damp from before, and I will take some of this on there, and I will just tap it into the skin. I am not baking, but I am pressing this powder down into the skin with a damp Beauty Blender. I didn't think this whole thing would actually work. I thought it would look terrible if I tried it. But this is my favorite way to set my concealer now, because it makes me just look airbrushed. Like, my skin is just airbrushed and it is so beautiful. And then I'm going in with my e.l.f. Professional Face Brush. And I'm just going to use this brush and that same finishing powder to set the rest of my face. And then I'm going in with this little Coastal Scents like blush and bronzer compact. As you can see, mine broke in the mail. I got it in my Birchbox and I got it and it was broken everywhere, but the bronzer is still good, so whatever. So I'm going in with my e.l.f. Actually, just kidding. This is my Eco Tools Precision Blush Brush, and I'm just going to go ahead and contour with this Coastal Scent shade. And then I'm taking this Milani Pressed Powder. It's actually like a foundation powder, but I just got the shade Amber. And it's like a few shades darker than my skin tone. And this works so beautifully for a bronzer. Whenever I saw this in the store, it's just, it's not very, very orange, but it's still warm, and it's just really, really pretty for a bronzer, and it's really cheap, too. So, if you're looking for a cheap one, this one is gold. So, I'm going in with my e.l.f. Complexion Brush, and I'm taking this Milani Pressed Powder, and I am just running this right over top of where we contoured, but I'm being a little bit more messy with it, and I'm bringing it up a little bit higher just to warm up the skin and bronze a little bit, make sure my contour isn't too harsh or anything. And then for blush, I'm going in with this Lorac blush in the shade Cinematic. It's kind of like a mauve-y brown color. And I'm applying this with my e.l.f. blush brush. I'm applying it to the back of my to the backs of my cheekbones. And then I'm working my way into the apples of my cheeks. Then I'm going in with this e.l.f. Baked Highlighter in Moonlight Pearls. And I'm applying this with my little e.l.f. Flawless Concealer Brush. And y'all, this highlighter is popping to be $4. Like, I got this at Target the other day and it was $4. And it works so good. I was so surprised. e.l.f. is really stepping their game up. And I'm applying this all over my face to all the high points. On my cheekbones, nose, the tip of my nose, my cupid's bow, chin, and forehead area. And then once I'm highlighted, I'm going to go ahead and take my Beauty Blender and my loose powder, and I'm just going to bake right underneath my contour. And then I'm going to go ahead and do my eyebrows. And I never really do my eyebrows on camera, mostly because I can't stay in frame while I'm doing them. But I tried for y'all. I tried really hard. I sped this up because if I didn't, then I would be, you guys would be sitting here watching me do my eyebrows for like 20 minutes. And I really don't think anyone wants to do that. But this is basically how I do my eyebrows every day. I draw a line underneath, and then I brush that out, and then I'll go on the top, and I draw a line on top of my eyebrows, but I do not make this one as dark. I want the bottom of my eyebrows to be really defined, but the top, I'm not too worried about. I don't want it to be really, really harsh and, you know, make me look manly or anything like that. And then I always take a flat brush with some concealer and just go right underneath the brows. And whenever I don't have a lot of product on my brush, I'll go above the brows and just clean them up and make sure they're nice and tidy. And then I'm going in with that Sonia Kashuk angled brush, and I'm taking the black shade, and I'm going as close as I can to my lash line. And I'm not really creating a thin line with this. I'm going pretty heavy because we're going to be blending it out. But I, no matter how heavy I go with this color, I still want it to be really, really tight into my lashes. And then I'm taking that It Cosmetics brush with some of, Chip. Yes, I'm taking Chip to blend out my lower lash line. And then I'm going in with that crease brush in the shade Jax just to blend everything out just a little bit more. Then I'm taking some more of In Light, and I'm going to go ahead and apply this color onto the whole inner part of my eye, even the inner corner of my lower lash line. And I love the way the inner corner turned out because I still had the black liner in my inner corner on the bottom lash line, but I still had that shimmering brightness of the In Light shade. And then I'm also taking the shade In Light, and I'm going to highlight my brow bone with this too. Now I'm just taking this color and applying it at the highest points of my eyebrows and then blending it out with this little e.l.f. eye defining brush. Then I went back through with my blending brush and blended everything, made sure there were no harsh lines or nothing like that. Then I went in with my e.l.f. Clear Brow Gel. And I always set my eyebrows. And I always brush my eyebrows up. Especially in the front. The front, I want my eyebrows to be very, very feathery. That's just how I prefer them. But I don't like my eyebrows to be feathery all the way through. Just on the front. Then I'm going in with a Stila Huge Lash or something like that mascara. You can just use whatever mascara you want. And I'm putting on like 3 layers of this mascara because I do not want to wear falsies. And then I went ahead and wiped off all the excess baking powder. And then for my lips, I started off with this little NYX High Voltage lipstick. And it was like a dark kind of brick red color. And I wasn't really feeling it too much. So I added this NYX Liquid Suede lipstick. And it's a very, very dark purpley color. And I wanted to mix the two together and just see what happened. And I wasn't feeling that either. So, long story short, the more time that went on, the darker my lipstick got until it was finally, I just put the purple all over my lips. And then whenever it dried, it was almost black. I mean, it was a really pretty color, but I was not expecting it to be that dark. That was not my plan with this, but it all worked out in the end, so whatever. All right. And this is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, be sure to leave me a nice comment or leave me a thumbs up. And also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks, everyone. Bye.
Some say he looks just like his father, but he can never love somebody's daughter. Football team loved more than just the game, so he vowed.